Hello everyone, HPI Guys Model Workshop here. Going to show you a re-release from Monogram. This is their Panzer IV tank. This was re-released just in the last quarter of 2014. And I know from looking it up and looking at the model itself that it's been re-released quite a few times over its life, as far as I can tell. It's been out for a very long time. In fact, it's been produced since 1970. And we'll show you proof of that in just a moment here. But as you can see, it is a standard Monogram packaging. It's an attractive actual look of a built model with a little bit of creative painting and Photoshop around it. They do give you some details on it. It is 197 pieces. It is 8 5/8 inches long. And it's molded all in olive drab and does come with decals. This is in 1/32nd scale, which is a little bit bigger than the standard 1/35th scale, but I think if you put them near each other and other tanks and other armored vehicles in 1/35th, you're not really going to notice much of a difference unless you're with a real negative nitpick, and then I wouldn't worry about it anyways because they're going to pick it apart because it's an inexpensive kit and it's not going to be the most super duper, you know, high-priced, premium, accurate kit, but it looks like a lot of fun. On the box here, you can see that they have beautiful pictures of the completed model. You can see that on there, there's your color options, and you don't have to do it their way, but it's just a recommendation. And if you take a close look, you'll see right there, there's some armor damage on there. And I'm going to show you a cool feature about the kit here in a little bit that helps you replicate that. So let's take a look at everything that's inside the box. First thing we're going to have is one set of trees, and those trees are right here. And like I said, everything's molded in olive drab, and it's all well done. This is the top of the hull, and you can see pretty good engraving. It's not obviously the super best, but even on this one, you can see that they took the time to mold in right there where my thumb is actual weld lines. So they even took time to do that. So for an inexpensive kit, I don't think, you know, that's all that bad. Usually that you to get weld marks and stuff like that, you have to have a higher end kit. So you can take a look. They got a lot of accessories with it, a lot of detail parts, a lot of separate parts. You can paint them and detail them separately before you assemble them. And we'll take a look. These are the side armor skirts. These are optional. You do not have to hang these on the model. You can put them on there if you want. They do include 4 gas tanks, 1.5. You can see. You can put those together quite easily, so that's really nice. And if you don't want to use those with those kits, that's looks like a standard type of a fuel tank, so you can use that with any other kit. One of the cool thing about this side skirt is this part right here, and you can see, we'll get up nice and close, it is a pre-damaged piece of armor. And to attach that, all you would do is take either one of the skirts that you wanted to use, and you would cut out 2 panels, and you'd want to use a razor saw or a brand new hobby knife and keep slicing down that seam. And it's nice that they put it right on the seam. And you would just keep scribing and scribing and scribing until on the back side of the plastic you would see a white line start to appear from the pressure on the plastic. And then you would be able to actually either snap it, or you could continue cutting from the other side and you'd have a nice clean cut. Then you could place this blown through armor piece on there and glue it in, and they include some nice tabs back here so that you can attach it to the back side of these plates. From here you'd attach it, glue it on the back, and then from the front it would look like one seamless plate that you could work on and weather. And this is a lot nicer to have in there than taking a soldering iron and making your own holes. They've got a couple different size holes and dents, so it looks like it would really blend in very nicely with some quality weathering. I think that's a nice little feature, and I'm glad that's in the box like that. This is the tank hull itself, and you can see the size of that. Like I said, the whole tank with a barrel 8 5/8 inches long, and you can see the hull itself right there against the measurements. Nicely looking, and you can see on the bottom where I got the information that's been being pushed out since 1970. So, you know, that's a good amount of time out there, and the molds still look good. It looks like they've been taking care of them. I didn't notice a lot of overshot on the plastic or a lot of issues with the mold. Even the diamond tread on the upper surfaces of the fenders is still in really good shape. There's not a lot of missed detail. It's deep enough that a good wash and some weathering will make it look real nice. The fronts of the fenders look good. So they've done a good job at keeping that mold in good condition and, you know, keeping up with it. Here's some more armor parts and a turret ring. Here's some more of the angle iron that you will use to attach the side skirts, the side armor skirts, which are, like I said, completely optional. You don't have to use those, so if you want to throw them in the parts box or use them for something else or not use them at all, that's up to you. And then this would be the armor on the turret, around the outside of the turret, which is hung the same way. And that's got some nice clear details on it. Nice work done on there. Very happy with this kit when I opened it up. I've never modeled it before, but when they decided to re-release it, and I happened to see it today, I decided to pick it up. And you can see right here parts of the mantlet. And there is a minor amount of flash on some stuff, and on other stuff it's completely clean. And that's to be expected with any older kit. And it's not any flash that's going to be hard to clean up. It's all very thin. And you can see the detail on the turret. Very nice. And we'll get in there. We'll see how close we can get in. See that weld detail right down the center? Very nicely done. Especially for the price, I'll let you know how much I paid for this kit. I paid $14 for this kit at Hobby Lobby with a 40% off coupon. So to get that kind of detail and that kind of material in there is actually really, really nice for the price. I think standard online price is around $19, and the price without a coupon is about $24 at Hobby Lobby. You can see there some of the mechanic detail on the plastic. Very nice rivets you can bring out with good detail. And we've got the road wheels. Those all look nice, crisp, clear. Just a little bit of sanding on the edges. Some detail painting, those are going to look great. Here's some extra track links. They can be used to decorate the hull. And you can see that one's got a pretty good size mark in it from being pushed out. So, you know, it's not much you can do about it. You can always flip it like this, which is the way I would definitely say to display it, and you don't have to look at those whatsoever. And that's probably how they would have mounted them anyways, would have been with the track side down, and they would have mounted the extra links and the extra track pieces on the hull this way anyways, so you don't have to look at it. You just have to sand off a little mold mark here and there. Otherwise, pretty good. Nice detail on those parts. They've got some thin parts here that are well done with not a massive amount of flash on them. Nothing to be concerned about. Everything will come off real easy with just a file. I don't even think you'd need a clippers on these. Just a small file will work just fine. Here's the last green parts tree. And this is more of the road wheel and suspension assemblies and drive equipment on here that you're seeing. And some extra track links, of course, again, for more detail. They would have had a lot of spare parts with them, depending on where they were going and what they were doing. And you can see back hatch detail. Very sharp on there. Actually, this, I think, would be the front of the hull here, not the back. This would be the very front, and I think these would be lights, as you'd see on there. And you've got your drive wheels. Very clean. Nicely done. And then, added little feature, they do include two figure kits of German military. Those are nice and crisp. Lots of detail. You can see those guys on there. Real nice. No problems at all. Just a minor little bit of edge flash where the mold was parted and they shot the plastic into it. You can clean that up without any problem. Paint those up. I think those would be a definite great addition to the kit, bringing a little life to it. It has two pieces of vinyl tracks, and they are somewhat rubbery. They're nowhere near as stiff as the other tracks I've shown you in some other less expensive kits. These are nice and soft. They wrap around a finger real easy. You know, they're not super, super stiff. So they should fit around the drive wheels and the axles without issue. And you can see the detail on those. And those will weather up and paint real nice with some acrylics. You shouldn't use enamel, like I always say, on the vinyl rubbery stuff, because it will never dry. Last parts in the kit are going to be the manual. And that's there. They made a booklet out of it, and they did break everything down into individual steps. Sometimes on these older kits, if they don't, you know, do the manual right, and then they re-release them, it's just like a 2 or 3 page exploded view, and then they can be a little confusing. But this is really, really straightforward. There's nothing wrong with that whatsoever. Very detailed. They break it into many separate steps, and then they do give you final assembly painting guides. They tell you how to assemble the tracks. They give you an idea of how to cut out that piece of armor plate and stick in the blown through one if you want to use that, or you don't have to. If you want it to look factory fresh, or that it hasn't taken any hard hits, you don't have to use it, which is nice. And if you want to use it, they put it right on the seam lines, like I said, which will be very easy to put that part in there. And they just have you assembling the turret, painting up the figures, attaching the turret, and they give you some paint options on the back in black and white, and you just use the paint codes in the front and decide how to paint that, or you can paint it just like the box art, and you can do it just like so, which is probably the way I would do it. I might not go with as much of a camouflage paint job. I might go with more of just a desert tan. They do have a nice size decal sheet with this model, and you can see that there. And what I think is cool is you have these markings here for two separate tanks in two different areas. And then they have these markings here, which are the same as these, but they've been pre-weathered. And they even say it right on there that they've been weathered. And I think that's a wonderful addition. You can see a lot of the scratch throughs, all the numbers, the emblems, you know, their division markers. They've all been as if they've been scratched and weathered, which does a lot of the work for you. You can wash over the top of that paint, you know, around there, and it's going to look real nice. So you can decide, and if you want to name your tank, you can name it Heidi or Paula, if those happen to be ladies that you're into, or you can name it whatever you want. Overall, I would give this kit probably an 8 out of 10, mainly because of the price that I got it for of $14, and because of the fact that it's a cool looking tank. It has lots of options. It looks like it's going to build very easy. And, it looks like a fun subject. So thanks for watching HPI Guys Model Workshop.